Hey, Stephen Warren Hill back with you for Chicago TARDIS 2020. Going virtual this year, as is very, very obvious. With me is my co-host, Nick Seidler. Nick, say hi.
Hi, everyone. How you doing? Just a little bit of housekeeping. At the last panel, we had some requests for some of the music that regularly gets played at Chicago TARDIS, which is composed by Rob Warnock, sometime myself, some other collaborators. You can find that music free on SoundCloud if you search Planet 14. And it's also possible to look for Chicago TARDIS music or opening theme to watch some of the openings and videos that we had. So just want to remind people about that. Also wanted to let people know that regardless of where you're watching from all over the world, if you are trying to figure out what time our panels are at, I just want to remind people that we are in using Chicago time. So that's GMT minus six to make sure that you can adjust and enjoy these panels. So back to you, Steve.
Okay. Yeah, we just closed out that Doctor Who music panel with our special guest, Mark Ayers. It was wonderful to see him. Now, we have something that I think is very special for you right now, and that is this guy does something pretty unique, I think. I don't know how much this goes on in the world, but certainly something I've never seen before. And here's an example that I have to share with you. This is painted on wood. This is me. Whoops, wait, that's me right there. This is a panel that we did on Red, White, and Who, the book that we wrote about the history of Doctor Who in America a couple of years back, 2017. And it was painted by Louis Achenbach, who I'm about to introduce to you here. He's going to give you a live painting demonstration. What he does basically, and I'll let him describe it in more detail, is he'll sit in the audience and he'll paint what's happening up on the stage. And I believe he gets a lot of his inspiration from music as well. So that's what he's going to do for us now. And this is really, I mean, this is like perfect for the virtual environment, I think, because unless you go up and stand over his shoulder at the convention when he's in person doing this, you won't really get a good look at what he's doing. And here we're giving him the opportunity to do that. So, Louis, welcome to Chicago TARDIS 2020. It's great to have you.
Thank you for having me, Stephen. I really appreciate the invite and the opportunity to do my thing.
You know, all right.
It's going to be very cool.
So, without any more interference from me, I'm going to let you do your own thing. Thanks, Louis. We'll see you in a little bit.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in to the live arts panel here at Chicago TARDIS. I got to tell you, I've been watching this thing this whole weekend, and this is really turning out to be a fantastic version of Chicago TARDIS. And this has been somebody who's been to, you know, a good half a dozen, a little bit more over the years. And, you know, like the St. John's ambulance thing last night, come on, the Sophie Aldred thing with Roz, you know, and the panel before this with Mark Ayers, this has been really great. And so this is all very inspiring me, and I'm glad that we can all, I'm gonna encourage folks to share when you have a thing going on, so you can, like, you know, share to other people that this is going on, not only live, but in the rebroadcasts. To reintroduce, my name is Louis Achenbach, and I'm a live painter by profession as a discipline. A good almost 10 years I've been doing this. My inspiration comes from a live setting and being in the room with musicians, mostly jazz musicians, contemporary artists, contemporary classical musicians, rock and roll stuff, all sorts of music. And as we all know, this past March, that sort of stopped in a lot of ways, right? Sort of like, so my lifeblood, my fix was slightly taken away, but not for very long, because I really jumped right into the virtual field, the virtual performance zone, which a lot of people have too. I've been doing this Thursday Night Life music series on Instagram Live, which is a split screen thing with myself and a musician. Those are on my Instagram page if you'd like to see that. But also doing things on YouTube and stuff like that. So I have a YouTube channel with a lot of live performances that you can all check out. One of the things, I mean, one of the reasons I'm here really is because not only am I a music fan, I'm a Who head, all right? And I'm very proud to say that I've been this way for a long time. So we're talking back in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. PBS was showing Tom Baker stuff. And I got hooked. And I was just like, you know, me and my dad would, you know, it would come on, we'd watch it. And I'm like, okay, I don't know, this is crazy. I'm sort of like into the show. And actually went to my first convention out there in Philadelphia and went to go see, Adric was there. And I was like, Matthew Waterhouse is there. And I was like stalking this guy in the elevator and stuff like that. And then I realized at the convention, it was so much more than Tom Baker. You know, we're talking, who's this other guy with the curly blonde hair that has it's his brother, Colin Baker. Oh, this is fantastic. You know, sort of like seeing all this stuff. What do you mean? There's like four other guys before this. This is crazy. So just got into the show and thank goodness for Big Finish for keeping it going all these years. I find the ability to use my imagination and put myself into the story is just sort of fantastic about this. I'm actually going to play some music while we are talking, and I'm going to do a little.
Welcome to Alltech Lansing.
Thank you very much. And I'm going to take you to do a little time traveling here and show you some of the artwork that I've done in the past at Chicago TARDIS. This is going to give you a little bit of a remember what it was like to be in the room with live music. All right. I actually want to hear you talk to yourself. So we'll sort of start, let's go back to just last year, right? So we got a little bit of, you know, this is the companions panel. You know, we're going Fraser Hines, Lou Jameson, Richard Franklin, Arthur Darville, Tosin Cole, Emma Campbell-Jones, and John Leeson. And, you know, I've gotten close enough that I can actually like sit right next to him these days. And it's my way of getting closer to the music. That's my way of getting closer to a show that I love very much. I'm gonna try to go through these slightly fast so I can, there's gonna be a performance, folks. Don't worry, I'm gonna, little time traveling here back to the same zone, that panel. You know, this is David Howe talking to Katie Manning and Lou and Richard and Arthur. Gonna say, I love doing this. Some of the ones, one of my favorite subjects to draw somehow is the head of Ross Rüdiger. Beware of the head of Ross Rüdiger. I just love drawing this guy's head for some reason. Here he is with Sylvester McCoy and Paul McGann. They're just doing their thing. And, you know, I try to stay away from caricature because that's sort of been done. And it's cool and everything like that, but I'm really trying to do a version of what it's like to be in front of these folks. And again, another Ross and Arthur. And I posted some of these on Facebook if you want to look at them in a different way. One of these fun ones that I think I got the word from Jason Hay Gallery that he probably wants this. And I have no problem with giving this to them. This is one from last year also. Big Finish panel. Lou and Katie and Jason and Fraser and John and Paul McGann. You know, so they're all there. You know, I try to, again, this is about me getting the essence of what it's like to be in the room, right? And just for giggles, Kevin Bacon. A lot of what I do is music groups and jazz ensembles and stuff. And every once in a while, I go to City Winery. And here's my 1 degree of whatever it is from Kevin Bacon. We both went to the same governor's school in Pennsylvania. Who cares? Now, if y'all remember last year too, we're talking, just Paul and Sylvester just doing their thing for like hours. I feel like these two could just take over the stage and let us enjoy them being there. I don't know. I miss it as much as you do, folks. But that's one of the nice things about this virtual world is we can sort of share this now and later on. Another head I like. Also, beware of the head of Stephen Shapansky. And he's got a few of my pieces, as does Ross. And here is here with Tosin Cole. He was a good companion there for a while. I kind of just got the word that right of these. Some folks are moving on. Hey, so here is Edward Russell, Katie Manning, John Leese, and Richard Franklin, Chicago TARDIS 2019. We'll do these fast. Edward Russell, Arthur Darvill. And you know, I'm close enough that I get to get like details of what they're doing with their hands. And I mean, this is fan art is high art. I'm doing this because I love the show, but I'm also doing it because I respect the show. I respect what these people do and what they're providing me as an artist in terms of elevating my own creativity. All right, some more time traveling to a year before, 2018. Fraser Hines, Wendy Padbury, Catherine Stewart, and Pearl Mackey, right? And again, not exactly a caricature, but they're all in there. And I get to look at these a day later, and I get to look at these couple years later, and remember what it was like to be there. I remember what it was like to be in the same room with these great artists and them sharing their stories, and they're sharing our life with us, you know, when they come to Chicago TARDIS, which they will again. This one's a little scary. Weeping Angel, Sarah Louise Madison from one of her panels with no legs for some reason. So one of my favorite parts of that they've been doing lately is when the actor or actress, just say actor, right, is when they hang out with the kids. So here's one of Pearl Mackey hanging out with the kids. I don't know. I just get a real big kick out of that process and just seeing the look on those kids' faces when they're on the stage with these great actors and remembering what it was like to be that young and loving the show. Another one of those is Colin Baker talking to the kids. I remember this one distinctly because I kind of remember, you got to just love the slight irreverence of Colin Baker and, you know, what he was saying to the kids, but also he's just like very, very sweet with them and very, just a delightful guy. And, you know, I get to walk around with this if I want to. All right, this one's a cool one. Again, this is one of our podcast friends, Lynn Thomas, and she was on a panel here with Fraser Hines, Janet Fielding, and Nicola Bryant. It was nice sort of actually running into Janet Fielding at one time and giving Peter Davison a painting. So he has one of my pieces. Very nice. Speaking of, here's another Shapansky hanging out with three doctors, Davison, Baker, and McCoy. And, you know, I'm sure of all of us, as a fan, this is like, you just gotta excruciatingly love that. All right, we'll get into something else here real quick, just because I have them and I made them up. Well, time traveling back to 2017. No, maybe this is 15. Bern Gorman with Elliot Serrano. Yeah. You know, and he's done some awesome things since then. And we're talking Alex Kingston, River Song, being on stage. Again, my process is I'm using my imagination all here time. So I'm allowing myself a lot of freedom of expression, which I'd like to think in some ways I've learned from the show, meaning the infinite possibilities of what you can do and taking a kernel of what you actually have as a gift and what you're able to do as a person or as an artist and taking it beyond that, right? The infinite possibilities of what you can actually do with yourself in these days. And I hope that people are taking this pandemic hiatus to work on themselves a little bit and finding out, you know, what can you do that no one else can do? This is one of my favorite ones of Paul McGann. Just a nice sculpture of a head that guy's got, right? Again, a lot of fun seeing him with the big finish panel the other day. John Levine. I remember distinctly being in the back of the room when John was there, and he decided I want a little screen time with this room, and got a little love from everybody. And I was talking before about meeting Janet and Peter at a hotel room, I guess, upstairs. And so I'm showing you these paper pieces because I don't own these anymore, but somebody else has purchased these. Again, this is what I do for a living. So Peter Davison has this one. I didn't sell it to him. I gave it to him. But another one I gave away willingly, and I will do it a million times with these folks, the big finish panel. And this was my introduction in person to Lisa Greenwood, the lovely and amazing talent phenom that is Lisa Greenwood. And I got to say hello because of this. Otherwise, I'm kind of just being like, hey, how you doing? What's going on? So instead of doing that, I show her a piece, and she's got it. She said, thank you very much. She loves it. She loves it. Little plug there. There she is with the actual piece. Everybody tune in later on. I think Lisa's on a panel with the Big Finish folks. And they have this one. This is Nick and Jason and Benji Clifford, who I am happy to network. And folks, it almost happened for this panel. It was a little too short notice for this one, but I dialogued with Dominic Lynn and with Mark Ayers and with Benji Clifford and the folks, Christian of Seva Team, to see if they wanted to do a live thing. It couldn't work out for this particular session, but it might. And lastly, here's one I've got of Nick and Jason, and they signed it. All right, what I would really like to do is get to work. Let's do this. I'm gonna play, I think, a little bit of what we saw last time, which was we talked to Mark. So I think I'm gonna do is play his Ghost Light. And I'm gonna jam. Enjoy. Just give you chills. Over to Dominic Glenn.
Travelling throughout the universe, I have battled against evil, against power mad conspirators. I should have stayed here. The oldest civilization, decadent, degenerate, and rotten to the core. Power mad conspirators, Daleks or tyrants, Cybermen. They're still in the nursery compared to us. 10 million years of absolute power. That's what it takes to be really corrupt.
Thank you.
Disperses, coalesces, reforms. Other patterns, other worlds. Nothing can be eternal. Thank you.
I'm having a really good time. Maybe too much of a good time. Guys, I could go all night.
So, a question for you. Because we're interrupting you because we have a limited amount of time, how does that interfere with how much you have planned in your head, or is it all just spur of the moment?
Yeah, I try not to plan anything. The best thing to do is to keep that pocket open, because that lets the full level of inspiration get in there. It lets the information from outside of the room come in and do its thing. I like to think of the painting as something that's done in the future. And then I simply just have to be the meat puppet that stands there and does this and listen. It's a lot to do with just listening, paying attention, and get out of the way of the creative process in a lot of ways. I mean, of course, I'm bringing whatever skills I have at the time. A lot of times that's what musicians are doing too. You know, if you're, you know, you've been doing this for 70 years, it might sound like it's improvised, but you're really bringing not only your 70 years of experience, but who taught you, and then who taught you, and then you go back into the ancestor line. So yeah, the answer to that question would be, I try to keep it open.
Okay, so, In a way, I feel like unless you're going to continue working on that piece, I feel like by interrupting you, I have somehow become a part of that piece because that was your.
That's true. No, you're in terms of a beat, or in terms of a breather. And again, silence is just as important as music in terms of composition and how you can process it. But a lot of ways, when the gig's over, the painting is done. I try to keep it like that. So this I think is going to be the way it is. I don't know if you guys can see, but I put a TARDIS shape in there, which is this guy right here. And you know, I like to think that we're all in our time capsule, right? We're all sort of floating around the universe, trying to see if the screen works and you can communicate virtually with everybody outside in the cosmos. And sometimes it works, and sometimes you get other channels and stuff like that. But your job is to pay attention and to be kind, and come on, just love each other, and that's it, right?
That's a fantastic message to close on. Lewis, thank you. This was wonderful. I'm so glad that we were in touch and we got this panel off the ground. Absolutely unique and terrific. So thank you so much. Nick, what do you have to say?
Actually, I just want to do a follow-up with Lewis. There were two questions that we got, and they're somewhat interrelated. The first question is that work that you just created now for sale? And then the follow-up question was, where can people see more of your artwork?
Right. Yes, it is for sale. That's my job. I would like to, and this is without getting permission from you guys, a portion of the sale of this or any other Chicago TARDIS Doctor Who related artworks that I would do in the next couple of days, I'd like to donate a portion of that to either one of the charities that you all are doing, or the St. John's Hospital, you know, the St. John's order that were, you know, from last night, something like that. But if that would occur, I would love to do that. I have a website. It's www.lewisachenbach.com. That's the website. It's not always current, but if you want to see what I'm doing, I've got a YouTube channel. I've got a Facebook thing. I've got an Instagram that has a lot of videos with live painting on it. Again, it's all Lewis Achenbach, and you can see it there.
Thank you very much for that. There's no other housekeeping that I have, Steve, other than to say a few more of our artists and vendors were posted on the Facebook page. So if people want to learn more, they can go there. Back to you, Steve.
Okay, so coming up next, we have Doctor Who board game creation. That is at 2:00 Central Time, coming up in about 10, 11 minutes or so. Be sure to join us for that. Once again, thank you so much, Lewis Achenbach, for a wonderful live painting demonstration. I liked your little dance during the rock and roll music.
I can't sit still. No. And Stephen and Nick, thank you all. And thank you for all the Chicago TARDIS staff. You're doing a great job. This is turning out to be one of the best years. So thank you so much.
All right. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you at the next panel. Onward, Chicago TARDIS.